Yo, what's poppin'? It's your boy from the C, the ATL Don, checking in. This week we got another sneaker pickup. This is from GOAT. This is a shoe that I slept on, and I wish I would have got it back in the day because it was sitting on shelves for a while before it finally sold out. Due to the increase in prices on the resale market for Jordans since the Last Dance documentary came out, the resale price was too high on them, so I ended up getting it looks pretty good in the pictures I saw on GOAT, a used pair. That's the advantage they have over StockX. You can buy used pairs on GOAT. So without further ado, let's get into this. All right, if you're a follower of the channel, you know I'm a Jordan 1 fanatic, as you can see behind me. Jordan 5 is my second favorite. I have a few pairs of Jordan 3s. I have never bought a pair of Jordan 4s before. So this is my first pair of Jordan 4s. I'm very particular on certain Jordan 4s and Jordan 3s that I like based on the colorway. I don't like all of them. So this is one of the few that I do like. This has been sitting for a while. Trying to remember, seeing what the shipping label says when I ordered it. Also, if you follow the channel, you know I'm very far behind on filming. All right. All right, Jordan 4, got the Jumpman Flight on the top, size 12, of course. Even got the trash bag stuff still in there. All right, got the authentication card from GOAT. GOAT sticker. Alright, as you can see, I scored the Jordan 4 Motorsport. I don't remember what I paid for these, to be honest. I wish I would have looked before I started filming the video. Overall, they look to be fairly good. Need to do some cleaning. The bottoms are a little bit dirty. Does have a little bit of toe box creasing. We can get that out. The laces are kind of dirty, and the Jumpman Flight logo's a little bit dirty, but we'll do a good cleaning up. They still got the cardboard shoe trees in them. The size 12 sticker is worn off in the insole. A little bit of sock lint. And the Air Jordan tag in there is kind of dirty, but we'll clean all that up. I got a little tool that actually will get rid of sock lint. Actually, I got it right here. And it's like a fabric shaver. And you just rub it over it and it'll eliminate that. It's the easiest way from what I've discovered to clean them up. The right shoe. Oh, there's some scuffing I didn't see on the picture. I'm going to wear these, so it's not terrible. It's got a little bit of a scuff there. They didn't list that in the description. A little bit of a scuff there too. This one has a little bit more toe box crease. I might could sand that area down a little bit in there and repaint those sections possibly. Should be able to touch that up. The bottom's, you know, of course, dirty from being worn. But I honestly don't remember what I paid for these. I'm gonna go grab my phone and look on the app real quick. I'll be right back. All right, sorry about that, I'm back. So I actually purchased these on July 7th, so these have been sitting for a good 4 months. I still have one pair I bought before these I still haven't done a video on. So I actually paid $150 for these, which, you know, is below retail what they would have sold for. I have to look and see. And it says issues with shoes. It says strings washed and minor creases. They left up a couple scuffs that was on there. But it is what it is now. I bought it used, right? Let's see what they're going for currently in my size. All right, so right now in my size, dead stock, they're going for $360. So if you look at it that way, I saved $210 going the used route. I highly suggest doing that if you plan on wearing them, because they're going to lose value when you put them on anyways. I usually have pretty good luck buying used ones on there. This isn't terrible. Like, you know, on feet, you're really probably not going to see that and that really that much on whenever you're wearing them. But I think I am going to sand down that area, then up here and touch it up. Kind of do a little minor restore job to them. But, so for the price, I think it wasn't that bad. $150 for my first pair of Jordan 4s. Stay tuned to the end of the video. I'll do a close-up. Hope everybody enjoyed today's video. Please give a big thumbs up if you did. Subscribe down below if you haven't already. Trends and Limited merch in the description. Till next time, it's your boy from the C, the ATL Don, signing out. Peace. Trim my claim to fame, mafioso be the